Hi there, I'm Ron Stauffer. This video is all about Success Criterion 1.1.1 non-text content, which is part of the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, also known as WCAG. And the most recent version, of course, is 2.1. So Success Criterion 1.1.1 is one of many criteria within the WCAG 2.1 guidelines. So let's get started. First of all, I'm going to read the guideline to you. The rule states, all non-text content that is presented to the user has a text alternative that serves the equivalent purpose except for the situations listed below. And then it lists a couple of exceptions. But it essentially, what it's trying to get at is any type of content on your web page that is not actually text needs to have text that explains what's going on. So for example, I've got here a picture called chart.jpg. Well, if I'm somebody with a visual disability and I can't see what's in that chart for whatever reason, but this chart was intended to convey something like, wow, look at that staggeringly high market share, you know, slice of the pie that Starbucks has of all the coffee houses in America, for example. If I can't see that visually, then this chart is not going to help me at all. Same thing with an image here. If I have a picture of, here, there's Ron.jpg, and I don't know what Ron's doing here. Maybe he's just looking at a camera. Maybe he's standing in front of a whiteboard, and it's a video thumbnail, for example. Either way, if it's an image, it needs to have alternative text. So images need what we call alt text. Technically, it's called alt attributes. And sometimes it's actually called alt tags. I frequently hear people saying alt tags. That's incorrect, and that actually refers to PDFs, which is a separate conversation. But if you're looking at an image of a chart, you need to provide, you as the website owner, as the content creator, the publisher, whoever, if you want to adhere to the success criterion, you need to provide alternative text. So if this is a chart that conveys meaningful information, then you might have chart.jpg and then alt text, and there's a way to code this in your HTML markup. But you know, your alt text would say chart that shows all coffee houses in America broken down by owner. Starbucks has 27%, whatever that is. So providing that alt text to help people understand what's going on inside this chart. Same thing with this image of Ron, whatever Ron's doing here. As I said, maybe he's just standing waving at a camera. Then you would have alt text that would say, Ron Stauffer waving at a camera. That way somebody who's using, let's say, a screen reader, can understand what's going on in Ron.jpg. If you don't give them that information, then what's going to happen is a screen reader is going to say Ron.jpg, and that's it. And then the user's going to wonder, Ron.jpg, what? Like, why is there an image of Ron there? What does that mean to me? What's that supposed to say? So providing alt text for images is very basic, but it's actually one of the things that I see people messing up the most, strangely. Videos are a lot more complicated because videos are inherently audible and visual. So you've got an audio-visual component where you can watch a video and glean information from what you're seeing, but also it's important to hear what's going on. So the guidelines for this non-text content states that you need to have transcripts, captions, and sometimes even audio descriptions. And audio descriptions are outside the scope of this video. They're a lot more complicated. We'll talk about them later in other videos. But a video needs to have a transcript and captions so that people who are blind, for example, if they're totally blind and they're relying on a screen reader, that screen reader can read the text and tell that user what's going on in the video. Also, if you know, somebody's watching a video and they're deaf and they have no ability to hear what's going on in the video, then transcripts are going to be incredibly helpful, because if you're watching a video of two people interviewing each other, you will have no idea what's going on if all you can do is see it. So if you can't hear it, you won't understand what the whole purpose of the interview is about, right? So you want to have transcripts, captions, and then audio descriptions. Again, that's a little bit more advanced, but that refers to something like a separate audio track or text track that would actually describe what's going on, not just what's being said. Like it might say something like President so-and-so steps up to the lectern in front of the US Air Force Academy or something like that. Well, that's an audio description. Again, We'll talk about that later. So videos need that. And then audio, obviously, audio needs a transcript. If you're not able to hear what's in an audio file, you're gonna wonder what it's about, unless you have the ability to either read it yourself, or, you know, some people are deafblind and they might use Braille. So there are actually Braille readers that some users can use to listen to your podcast. They'll push play and then they can actually feel in a tactile sensation what's going on in your audio file. But they can only do that if you have transcribed it. Assistive technology is good enough to the point where it can convert meaningful text, that is, to all kinds of different ways of helping the user understand what's going on. As I mentioned, you've got screen readers which speak aloud. There are some Braille devices that people can use to understand what's going on in a video without hearing or seeing. That's pretty amazing. But almost all of those assistive technologies rely on converting text into whatever medium or format they use. So all of your non-text content needs to have text content associated with it. And it's, quite honestly, this is very, very simple stuff. It's pretty basic. It's the very first success criterion, but again, it's the one that I see broken more than almost any other success criterion, except for contrast. That probably, contrast errors probably come in a close second, but you know, the number of times that I've gone to do an accessibility audit on a website and I've seen chart.jpg with no alt text, I can't tell you the number of times that's happened. So that's what Success Criterion 1.1 is all about. Hopefully that makes sense. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for more.